Dr. Christy Ennis, physical therapist, women's health specialist, certified strength and conditioning specialist, and nutritionist. And today I want to talk to you guys about how to get rid of pain with sex after menopause. Now, menopause, there are a lot of special changes that happen, as you guys probably have already seen in your own bodies. But when we're specifically talking about sex, we're talking about the pelvis. And with that decrease in estrogen comes a decrease in lubrication, so it's a little drier down there, and also an issue with the kind of the strength of the walls of the vagina. So those get a little weaker, a little thinner, and a little drier too. But the good news is you can actually do something about those things, and a lot of people don't realize that. So number one, lubrication is key. You can never really over-lubricate, but you can always under-lubricate, so keep that in mind. You want to look for something that is either water-soluble or silicone-based, and the one that I tend to have my patients use a lot is called Slippery Stuff. I wish I did marketing for these things because they're super fun names. But the website I use is Current Medical Technologies as well, and they do a really great job of getting this stuff to you. Excuse me. Again, silicone-based or water, that's really important so that you actually don't increase dryness. Believe it or not, things like Astroglide and KY jelly that we see in the stores tend to actually increase dryness. Not good. Not what we want at all. The other options, and this you need to talk to your doctor about, certainly is hormone replacement therapy. But then there are a couple other drugs that work on lubrication as well, Osfina and Intravosa. Again, those are newer drugs, and you certainly need to talk to your physician about that. My goal is to try to get you to do things without the medication, so that's where the lubrication comes into play. Now, secondly, when we're talking about dryness, as we get older or just sometimes get sick, there are some medications that actually increase dryness as well. So cold and allergy medications, cholesterol medication, cancer medicine, and blood pressure medicine all are going to increase dryness everywhere. So sometimes you'll notice you'll get a dry mouth. Well, that also happens in the vagina too. So you might need some extra lubrication if you're on any of those medications. There are some other medications too that probably cause an increase in dryness, and always check with your pharmacist. They are the best people to talk to you about side effects from any medicine. They know it all, trust me. So that deals with the dryness aspect. Now, when we're talking about pain in there, typically what happens with vaginal atrophy, right, that's what happens after menopause starts to happen. The pain usually occurs at the introitus, which that's just the opening to the vagina, and then right inside. So it actually tends to be very surface. So besides the lubrication, one of the things that can really help kind of open that area up a little bit and loosen some of those things that want to do this is actually what's called a dilator. So they come in different sizes, and it's just like if you were to try to stretch your muscles, you'd want to do something, right? You either massage it a little bit or you kind of pull it. You can't do that inside unless you do something internally. And that's where the dilator comes in. So typically, because that pain is so towards the front, usually I have people just start gently placing that dilator in, using that lubrication, and then working just on stretching back and forth. And that really makes a big difference. Focusing in on a little bit of diaphragmatic breathing at the same time. So when you breathe in, belly rises. When you exhale, belly comes back down. That actually helps to relax the pelvic floor muscles. So even when you're talking about any form of penetration, doing that type of breathing can just help make things that much easier. So that's important. The other thing that I tend to see a lot of is that women that have had any type of abdominal surgery, even laparoscopic or arthroscopic, and especially C-section scars, tend to actually cause pain vaginally or deep pelvically as well. So if you've never worked on those scars and they're sensitive to the touch and there's scar tissue buildup, that actually can translate internally too. And as we get older, the elasticity of our body isn't quite the same, so those scars actually tend to get worse. So doing cross friction, so if your scar goes this way, you're gonna go against the grain of that scar, can actually help to release some of that. It's gonna be a little tender at first, but it really does make a difference. And then that leads into as well, if we're talking about elasticity, all of our muscles and ligaments start to lose some of that elasticity, so we get tighter and tighter in other places too. So we have hip muscles that attach in those same areas. These inner thigh muscles attach into the pubic bone. We have some hip rotator muscles that also attach in that area, so we want to get those loosened up. So if you take a Derma Edge or something similar and really work on just nicely, gently getting blood flow back to those areas, easy, gentle. It's a great way to help loosen up some of those tight areas. You can get through the outside of that hip too. All of that stuff that's attaching into that area. So that makes a difference too. And then follow it up with a nice gentle stretch. You can even do a lovely seated stretch. And I'm really tight, so this feels really good right now too. And that's, excuse me, a nice easy one to follow up with after you've worked on those muscles. So those are some area specific to some hormone stuff going on that you can really work on to make a difference and become more comfortable again. So this is important for both you women and you men, because it takes two people here. So thank you again for tuning in. If you liked this video, please share it with anybody you think might benefit from it, because there's so many people out there that don't know that there are things that you can do for this. And stay tuned for more. Thank you.